H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So I welcome all of you to this demo session on mobile application testing with Appian. In today's class, I will give you a quick demo. Before giving the demo, I will take you through the contents of this course, what I target to teach you or introduce you, okay, with the tool Appian. As you know, Appian is an extension of Selenium. A few prerequisites for this course is a little bit knowledge about Java programming. If you know Selenium, it is very good, then learning Appian is just a cakewalk. Okay. And if you don't know Java also, like I think one of us, Ramuni is there, who has been into manual testing and very less knowledge on programming. So I will be giving a refresher course, Ramuni, on Java, which you will need for Appian. So that it's not that you are not understanding Appian or you're not understanding how to write the scripts. Okay, so I'll teach you, I'll give you a refresher course. Okay, a quick refresher, one day class on what all you need. But it is your practice on Java, your knowledge on Java, which will help you to become an expert in Appian. I'm not going to make you an expert in Java, but an expert in Appian. So we have one more joining. I would recommend you to put your own name so that it is easy for me to refer. Like I have a name A, I have FF. Please put your names. You can right click in the go to meeting where you go. Right click on your name and change the name. Or rather you can go to meeting. Yeah. On the top, do you see go to meeting? Edit your name and email. Please edit your name so that it will be easy for me to refer to make a note of that. Otherwise, referring as AFF, it's a little not so easy for me. Okay, all right, it's all right. If you want to change, you can change. Okay, where was I? Prerequisites for this course. Prerequisites are at least one programming language that you need to know is Java. If you don't know, it's all right. I will give you one day a refresher course on that. And then it is your practice, your effort to learn more about Java and implement that in your Appian script. Okay. The course is going to be about Appian, which is an automation tool for testing mobile applications. Okay. As a flow for today's class, we will go through the contents. I will give you the topics that I'm going to teach you guys. Okay. Then I'm going to give a quick demo on how Appian works. We'll see the different architecture. I'll not explain the architecture today. It's not possible to explain it in one demo. But once the class starts, I'll be able to give you the architecture. Okay. And we'll see the different components that goes inside to do mobile application testing. Okay. And then I can take your question and answers after that. Okay. The schedule for this class is yet not decided. Okay. Daniel will be able to confirm you on the schedule for the class. It is going to be 1 hour class, okay? And I think it is going to be from Monday to Friday class, okay? All right. So I have prepared a quick content for you and a day-wise break of what we're going to cover, okay? The all of this particular training should be for 20 days. I target to finish it in 18 to 20 days because I think most of us already know TestNG frameworks. We have an idea about Selenium. So teaching those things will be easy for me. Okay. It'll just be a refresher. Okay. We'll not spend much time on understanding Java or downloading Java. So that'll save us some time. So instead of 20 days, we should be able to finish in 18 days. Okay. That is one thing. So I still see some of us joining. So give me a moment, guys. Let's let everybody join. Okay, so let us go through the content. The notes are already available with me. So I already have the notes. I already have the topics that we're going to cover. So it's going to be a very strictly followed course. We're going to stick to all the topics and follow those and try to finish on time. Okay, Now, in the first 3 days, we're going to go through the basics of mobile application testing. We're going to see what is mobile application testing, importance, why we have to do mobile application testing. Now, in mobile application testing, guys, we have different applications, types of applications. You need to understand these three types of applications in order to test them. Okay, in today's demo, I'll give you a quick introduction to what are these applications. Not in detail, but an introduction to them. Okay, what are the three types of applications that you can find on a mobile device? Okay, how to test them? Okay, that we're going to see as later in coming days. Okay, then there are different platforms on which you can test your application. What are the different mobile platforms? Android is one of the platform, iOS is one of the platform, Windows, BlackBerry, right? By platform, we mean the types of OS, mobile OS that we have. So if you see your phones, just I'm sure they're next to you. So you may have OnePlus, you may have Samsung, you may have Motorola, you may have Google Nexus, any phone on that. That is an Android platform. If you have iPhones, okay, iPhone 8, 9, 10, and the latest version, then your iPhone OS or your platform of your device is iOS. Let's say you have a Nokia phone, or you will have Windows. BlackBerry, I don't find anybody using it now. So we'll leave that platform. Guys, we'll also not work with Windows because very rarely it will be used. So we'll stick to Android and iOS platforms. Two platforms for our training also. Okay. Next, what are the different types of testing that you can perform on mobile applications? Okay, I will rename it. People who are into manual testing, they will know about what are the different types of testing, functional, non-functional testing, black box testing, okay, performance testing, usability testing, security testing. But how they have to be implemented, we are going to discuss the scenarios or examples, okay, how they have to be used in case of mobile applications, in case of different mobile applications, okay, and we are going to try to understand the approach for mobile testing, guys. How we are going to do the mobile testing in addition to doing it manually. Okay, now when we move to automation, we will be using a tool. Okay, the tool should be able to interact with our application. Now let's say our application, we will understand it can be native, it can be hybrid or web application. You can have one of the device, okay, a platform, maybe one is an Android device and one is an iOS device. Now you can test in three different ways, guys. You can test it in an emulator. You can test it on a real device, your applications. You can test it on cloud. Okay. We're going to learn what are these three approaches. What is an emulator? What is a real device? And what is cloud testing? We're going to see all of that. Okay. So basically, our course will concentrate on testing on emulator and real device. Testing on both together also. Cloud, let me see if I can provide that to you. Okay. But mostly I will concentrate on emulator and real device. Okay. So we'll try to understand all of those. So these 3 days are going to be really introduction and a theory class with real-time examples which I have encountered in my project. I will be sharing those with you. Okay. Next. After that, once we understand what is application testing, what are the different applications, what are approaches, we will start with the setup of APMs. Setting up of Appium is the most important thing. If you already know Selenium, writing Appium scripts is easy. Okay, if you know Appium, then writing Selenium also becomes easy. You can easily understand Selenium. It's vice versa. I feel like that, but everyone can have their own opinion on it. I feel that way. Now, before we write the script, setting up of Appium is very important. So that setting up of Appium will at least take 2 days for us. It's a step-by-step process. And we should not miss any of the steps. In case we miss any step, then our setup will be missed and we have to again, you know, we may face issues when we are executing the script. Okay, so it's a step-by-step process of first understanding the architecture of APM and then configuring it. Guys, I have concentrated on this particular training as for Android platform only. The training will concentrate on testing of the applications on Android platform. The reason being why I cannot do with iOS. First of all, Appium is a tool which supports both It supports Android and iOS platform both. But in trainings, we can easily teach you, or we can give you examples, or we can do the setup much better for Android. Okay, it's a freeware tool, Android Studio. We can easily create the emulators, and we also have the real devices, and we can use it on Windows machine and show. But in case of iOS, we do have challenges when we are setting up of the environment. Okay, creation of the simulators. Most important is finding the iOS applications. Okay, though the Appium architecture remains the same for both. Okay, so you will not face any issues with the Appium working with Android and not working with iOS, or learning Appium separately for iOS. It's not required. It is the same thing, iOS and Android, same Appium script, just that the platform will change. Okay, so I will concentrate on, my training is concentrated on working with Android platform. Please note that. Okay, now, so during the configuration, we will do the setup for Android Studio. We'll set up Android client. We will set up Android desktop server, UI automator, and all the other things required. We will also create a virtual device, which is called as emulator, to execute our scripts. Then I will be teaching you, we'll be going through ADB commands, which are bridge, Android debugging bridge, okay, which will help us to connect our device to our machine, to see the different devices connected to our machines. There are a few commands which you need to know. We will also see how to do parallel testing in this 6 days, okay. So we can divide 3 days, 3 days, wherein 3 days we are doing the setup and we are checking our setup is correct. Then next 3 days we can start with learning the native app, trying to do the testing in native app, and then doing a parallel testing. What is parallel testing is, I'm going to execute one script. Script is a scenario, okay? It's a test case, okay? One script in two different devices, parallelly. Okay, these two devices could be a virtual device. I'll show you what is a virtual device in a moment, and a real device, a device that we have. Okay, so we'll also do a set of parallel testing over here. Okay, then we're
going to... are you showing your screen? Sorry, ma'am, are you showing your screen? Because I cannot see anything. I don't know about others.
Yes, that's the same thing. Okay, I'm sorry, I didn't share my screen. Thanks for letting me know. Okay, sorry. So we'll just show you again. Same things. Here, day 4, day 12, till day 12, we're going to do all these things. We're going to start with the architecture of Appium. We're going to do the configuration of Appium and Android Studio. Then we are going to do the ADB commands and Java introduction. Okay, here I'll just take 1 hour of class where I'll introduce you with Java, just a refresher course. Then we're going to understand specifically what are desired capabilities. These desired capabilities are much needed for connecting to our devices. Now, either it is an Android platform or an iOS platform, the difference will be in the desired capabilities. Appium methods, Appium API commands will remain the same irrespective of the platform. Only the capabilities will change, guys. Okay. And then we will see UI automator. We will also do parallel testing, as I was just explaining. We will take one single script executing in two different devices at the same time. Okay. We'll first begin testing with native app. What is a native app? I'm going to explain in a few minutes. Okay. Web app, and then move on to hybrid app. Okay. We also have Appium gestures, which are tapping, pinch, okay, zooming in, zooming out. When we work with mobile application, there are certain actions that can be done on a touch screen, okay, multi-touch actions. You're going to do that in this particular section, okay, and then key events, entering the data from the keypad of your mobile device, okay. Towards the last days, we are going to work with network management methods which Appium provides, and a few performance testing methods are available in Appium. We will look at those and see the performance of our application. Okay. So I'll again go back on the top and explain you, because I think I wasn't sharing my screen. So I told that we're going to start the training. Okay, and the training is going to be for 18 to 20 days. I target to finish within 20 days. As most of us are already aware of, about Selenium, aware about certain frameworks, so it becomes easy for you guys to understand the course. Okay, the most of the challenge that you're going to have is setting up of the config Appian and Android Studio. It's really complex, and also it needs a lot of space in your machine. So if you're signing up for this course, do check that your RAM is at least 8 GB. Okay, get the setup done. I'll show you how to do the setup. We'll do step by step. Every step has to be followed so that when we run our script, we don't face any issues. It's a one-time activity. Once done, shouldn't be any problem in future. Okay. And you will also learn about UI Automator, as I just told you. In the beginning, the first 3 days is going to be more of understanding what is mobile application, what are the different types of applications, and the platforms and approach for mobile testing. As I was telling you, the approach of mobile testing could be emulator, real device, and cloud testing. So all of this is what we are going to cover as part of this training. I've tried to provide the days also as to on which day we are going to finish which topic, so that we are clear on the progress of our training. Okay, we are going to concentrate on Android Studio, guys. On Android, not Studio, Android platform and APK files. I'll be sharing the details about it during the class. Okay. Now, let me quickly give you a demo about what is mobile testing, okay, and the different types of applications. Just a quick demo, and then I'll show you how to, I'll execute a script, Appium script for you, and how it works on a virtual device. Okay, so let me open a notepad for you. Sorry, I wasn't sharing my screen, I just missed that. Okay, so just to give you an idea. Now, what is mobile application testing? Guys, if you see your just next to you, you will have your mobile devices, right? On the device, we have so many applications. Those applications could be our games application, applications related to news, applications related to food delivery, applications related to grocery delivery, applications related to movies, entertainment. Uber is an app. So we have multiple applications on our devices. Testing the functionality of applications. Okay, now here functionality and performance of an application is mobile application testing. Now this testing of functionality, okay, or this testing can be done manually or using an automation tool. It can be done manually or using an automation tool. Okay, now for testing a mobile application tool, there are multiple automation tools available in the market. Manually, you already know how to test it manually. Just go to the application and test, execute your test cases yourself. Okay, but that becomes very tiring because you have so many platforms to test. You have so many devices to test. Guys, understand that when you are testing an application, you will not test it only in one device, your device, and you will say testing is complete. No, testing is not 100% complete. You should take devices in different platforms, test your applications in that. Okay, you should test your application in multiple devices. Okay? Around the world, there are thousands and hundreds of devices. You should be able to test in at least devices which are mentioned by the client, and then finish your testing. Now, testing that manually will take a lot of time, right? You may have limited resources. So in such cases, automation testing comes very handy, use of an automation tool. There are multiple automation tools available in the market for mobile application testing, which is Celandroid, Calabash, okay, and Appian. Now, Celandroid and Calabash basically are the tools which are used for Android platforms only. Okay, Appian is one such tool which can be used for iOS and Android also. That's why it is gaining more and more of its popularity. Plus, it is an open source tool. It is very easy to understand also. Okay, does not need that you need to know the application source code. But when you work with Cylindroid or Calabash, you need to know the application source code to work with the tool. Here, you don't need to know that. Okay. Then, so Appium is the tool which is used for automation testing, and you can test the functionality and performance of the application with the help of Appium. Now, when I talk performance, you can also use JMeter to test the application performance. Appium does provide few metrics for performance testing. Okay. And next, now these few applications, let me first introduce you the platforms that we have. Okay. So the platforms can be Android, as I was telling you, and iOS. Okay, we're going to concentrate only on these. Android platforms are the devices that we have, like Motorola, Samsung, Google Nexus, we have OnePlus, all those have platforms iOS. Now, Apple phones, which we use, they have a platform called OS, iOS. Okay, this is an open source platform. Anybody can take the use this platform, build their applications, and deploy it on Android phones, Android tablets, Android TVs. Okay, but iOS is a closed platform, guys. Not everybody can use it. It's not an open source platform. Okay, only the team of Apple can use it. That is another major challenge that we face when we are testing, when we're training you with Appium. Okay, but when you are in your test environment, in your projects, I'm sure you're going to have the entire setup for iOS, which is easy for you to get the application file. You're going to easily create the simulators also. Okay. No. Another introduction point over here in mobile application is devices. Okay, so as I was telling you, you can have an emulator, that is a virtual device. I'll show you a virtual device. So let me show you a virtual device. But for creating a virtual device, you will need something called as Android Studio. Okay, so one second. Okay, let me start it from here itself. I'll show you Android Studio also. Okay, before it starts, let me start from here. App data. Okay, just starting my virtual device. I'm starting my virtual device, okay, to show you what actually an emulator or a virtual device means and how we can have an application on it and how we will do the testing, just to give you an idea about it. Okay, so this is a command that we use to start our virtual device. So I have a virtual device with this name. Okay, I'm also trying to show you Android Studio. It will take few minutes to start the device. So do you see here something? And this is our device here. It's starting. It's just like your real device, guys. The only thing is that it is virtually available on your machine with the help of a software. We are creating it. It has the same platform as that we have, or OS as that we have in our real devices. It has the same setup configuration as that we have in our devices. Okay, just that you are, it's there in your machine. Now, similarly, you can create multiple virtual devices for your testing, and you can test your applications. Different devices you can create. Like this, I think, is a Google Nexus phone. You can create a Samsung phone. You can create a Motorola phone. And look, this is your device. Looks like a real device. Okay, this is one way of testing. Emulator. Next is your real device. Okay, so you connect your real device to your machine and you can start testing, have the application in it. How will you get the application? From your app store you can get it, or the development team will give you the .apk file and you can load it in your device. Okay. Third thing is cloud testing. So you can use cloud test environments like Sauce Labs. These are paid environment guys. Okay, so I'll have to check with H2K if they can buy me the Sauce Labs platform so that we can see cloud testing. Otherwise, I'm also exploring browser stack, okay, which is also a freeware online environment, guys. What is a cloud test environment? It is a free online, or it is an online environment for testing your applications. You can test web applications, you can test mobile applications there manually or using an automation tool. You can use Selenium also or Appium also in these cloud test environments. Okay, so here emulator, they in the cloud testing also we have emulators, virtual devices only, okay, which are just like our real devices. The one that I showed you is in your machine. So your machine needs to have really good amount of memory to hold 5 to 6 emulators, because if you open 3 emulators, your machine becomes really slow and testing in it becomes difficult. Okay, so at a time parallelly you can test on 2 emulators, which is all right. Okay, but in cloud testing, it is an online environment. You don't have to download anything in your machine. It will start testing everything. You can start with multiple devices. You will have thousands of devices on cloud environment, but you'll have to buy it. It's not freeware. Like Android and this virtual devices are free. Okay, but this we have to purchase. I think $30 a month. Okay, so if your project can support that, then you can buy the cloud test environment and test your testing over there. Then you can test in real devices or in cloud. Using Appium also, you can test in cloud test environment. Using Appium, you can test on an emulator. Using Appium, you can test on a real device. Okay. Now, so when you have a virtual device, let's say I have an application here, API demos. Let's take a basic Android application, which comes with every Android emulator. So this is an application. It's an Android platform tool. Okay. Now, talking about the applications, guys. Okay. Your applications can be native applications. It can be web applications and it will be hybrid. So nowadays, all most of the clients, most of the customers are going for hybrid applications. People who had web and now opting for mobile apps also to be built, they're going for hybrid applications. Okay, but if a client wants an application which is to be really the performance of that application has to be very good. Example is gaming applications, the performance has to be really good. E-commerce applications, right? They should be able to load the products immediately, plus high user usability apps interface. Okay, just like in e-commerce websites. So those applications will be native applications. Other applications can be hybrid. The difference between them is native applications are very costly to build. Why? Because these applications are built separately for Android and separately for iOS. Hybrid are very easy to build. Okay, same code can be used in Android and iOS. We'll learn about these in the first 3 sessions. A very detailed explanation about each application. Web applications are applications that we run on our browser of the device. You go, this is a native app. Okay, this is a native app. Now, if you go to the browser of your device and you open over there, h2kinfosys.com, let's say. Okay, or anything. So, or google.com when you're opening. So this is an app. This is a web app. Okay, so these are the 3 applications that we are going to test. We are going to take examples of each of these applications and test it using Appium. Okay, that is one thing. And another thing that, okay, now let me show you Android Studio. So this is how an Android Studio looks like. I'll show you how to do the setup for Android Studio SDK manager, and we'll create a virtual device using this Android Studio. It should be there in your machine. So you need at least 5 GB of empty space to create an Android Studio. Okay. So suppose you're going for cloud testing, then you don't have to do the setup for Android Studio or create the emulators. You can easily make use of the devices available on the cloud environment. Okay. Now, Appium client is available with me, and this is called as Appium server. Okay, we're going to do the setup for this. I'll stop the server and create again. Okay, so we'll start the server. I'll show you how to quickly execute an Appium script for you. Okay, just to show you the flow on how the Appium works. I have my Eclipse. I have some scripts written over here. You guys have, before executing the script, I'll explain you the scenario also. Do you guys have any questions till now? Any questions? Anything that you want to ask? Yes or no, please? Any questions about the contents? Any doubts? At least type yes or no. Did you understand what I explained till now? What are the different platforms that you will be working with? What are the different devices? How does a virtual device look like? Are you guys able to hear me, guys? Can you hear me? Okay. How about others? Okay. All right. So now let me quickly show you how to. So we'll write the small scripts, big scripts, depending upon the scenario. Okay. So I have. Other training. So let me open a script. Yeah.
Hi. Hello.
Kalyani.
Yeah, I have a question. What is a virtual device?
An emulator. Virtual device is the one that I showed you. This is a virtual device, a device which is virtually available in your machine, in your laptop or on your desktop. It looks just like your real device. It has the same platform as that of your real device. If I show you the configurations. Okay, it has it's a replica of your real device, to say you in easy terms. Just that you're not holding it. It's not available with you in front of you, but it's there on your machine. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
It's a simple Android device. It is versions is Android 6. Okay, and these devices are also provided by Android team itself. It's not any other software that we are using to create an emulator. It is provided by Android team itself. Okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Thank you.
And there was one more question as how much programming knowledge is needed. So if you don't have, if you've not taken Selenium classes or if you have no knowledge about programming earlier, so very little knowledge about Java on how to create a class in Java, how to create methods in Java, how to call existing methods in Java, how to create an object in Java. These four or five things are more than sufficient for you to begin with the course. I will anyways be spending one day of time with you to teach you the basics of Java, which you need for my training. Okay, Mani? All right. So let me give you a... Don't want to execute this one. Okay, so I'll just give you a demo script, okay, which is going to do the testing in your virtual device. Okay, my test case is my Appium tool should connect to this device. It should connect to this device. It should go to this API demos application. This is an application in my phone. Okay, go to this application, open the application. This is the front page. Click on this preference button here. In this, click on preference dependencies button here. And I think it's going to check this box. Click on this checkbox. Okay, that is my task as part of my Appium script. So this is a scenario, a simple scenario with my native application. Click it. So basically on your applications, what you do? You send some data, you click on some tabs, you click on a menu option, you swipe it, you tap on it, and all. Correct? Okay. So in order to click an Appium or to work with Appium, the first thing is Appium should be able to read your device. Okay, which device you want to connect to. So the name of my device is Sonalt Demo June. Let me recheck it. Yeah. So this is the name of my device. You will give the platform. Suppose you're working with iOS. You will give an iOS platform here. The only difference between Android and iOS, guys, will be the capabilities. Okay. So you'll give iOS and you'll give the platform version. Now I'm using Android, so I'm giving Android the version, and you'll give the details about the application. And then we will connect to the driver. Sorry, we'll connect to the Android server and execute the steps. So let me execute this. I'll be teaching you how to write the APM script and its methods. Okay. If you see, we are using the Selenium find element by XPath and all locator, same thing which we have in Selenium. We are going to continue here. That's why the course is very small. It's not very lengthy course. Makes use of the Selenium components only. Okay. Selenium commands rather. Okay. But we do have a mobile element, some other classes which are specific to only Appian. Okay, sorry about that. Okay. One moment, guys. I think I have the script which runs on the same device. Okay. One moment, just guys, one moment. Just picking up two things so that it's much clearer to you. I'm just making changes in the device, and then we are adding some steps here wherein it is going to wait for 5 minutes. We are going to click on preference. We are going to click on preference dependencies there. Okay, after that we have to click on the Wi-Fi button. That is what I have told you. Okay, we'll quickly write that. So the action that we are going to do is click on it, isn't it? What we are doing, we are trying to click on preference button, then we are going to click on preference dependencies, then we are going to click on checkbox. Okay, that's all. So if there was somewhere where you want to enter the data, then you can, you know, select that element and enter the data. So execute it. So before executing, we should always make sure the server is up and running. So download the server and we'll make sure it is up and running. And then just execute it. Let us see if we have the main method here. So if you see, the server logs will start as soon as you execute the script, and the script will get executed in this device. In this virtual device, the script will get executed. I've given this device. Suppose you're working with your real device, you will give the name of your real device. So it started executing Appian. It is trying to locate the device. First and foremost, it's going to get the access to the device. Okay. Then it is going to open the application that we have mentioned. Okay. See, it has opened API demos. Clicking on preference, it's going to click on preference dependencies. It's going to check on Wi-Fi. That's all. When you get a 200, that is a green, that is a success. If you get 500 in red, that means there is an error. So we'll also learn how to read the logs. Okay. So that's how an Appian works. A simple, very, very simple example on how Appian works with a virtual device. Similarly, if you're working with your real device, the only difference will be you will give your real device name, you'll connect your device to your machine, give the platform name, version, and then execute. Everything else remains the same. iOS also the same way. But in iOS, your application will change, guys. will not be an APK application, it will be an .IPA application, iOS application. In iOS, you will not have an Android device, you will have a simulator there, okay, which you will use Xcode, you can use to create it, or you can use cloud testing. All right. So any questions over here? I want to stop the demo over here. Now you can ask your questions. And did you like the demo? I close all of these. Yes. Any questions, guys? Anything that you want to know about mobile applications, about this training, how it is going to be? Anything that you have doubt about? Did you like the demo? Yes or no? Did you enjoy at least? It's okay if you're not registering.
Yeah.
But did you enjoy the
I liked your demo.
Demo.
Yeah, it's very good.
Right. And
I'm able to understand you. Yeah.
Right. So everything will be taught step by step. Right. Great. So any questions? As I told you, this training is going to be for 20 days. Okay, we'll target to finish as early as within 18 to 20 days. But it's okay. If we have not finished it, we'll extend it for next another couple of days. I'm all right with that. Understanding and step-by-step going through each and every topic is important for me. Then the training is going to be for 5 days a week, Monday to Friday. Timeline, we have to check with Daniel which time he's going to schedule. Accordingly, we'll have it. Okay, and if you have liked the demo, do register for the class because I'm eagerly waiting to start an APM class. My Selenium batch is about to finish this week, so I'm planning to start with APM. So register yourself with the training team so that we can quickly start the mobile application with APM. Okay, any more doubt, anything that you want to ask about the course? These are the contents that we are going to do. You also need to understand that you also need to know that APM is a growing tool. It is becoming much and much popular nowadays because every customer that we have will be in need of mobile application. Any domain that you take, earlier they wanted web applications. Now it is that every customer along with web application need a mobile applications to build their business. So testing of mobile applications becomes much more important. Okay, so you should have the skills to test a mobile applications. If you're doing it manually now, you should, it's a high time that you should learn the tool. APM is the most commonly used tool when compared to Celentroid, Calabash, okay, to test a mobile application. All right.
Yeah. Hi, I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so what is this APM like? Is it a tool?
Yeah, it is a tool. Just like Selenium, it is also an open source tool which is used for testing mobile applications.
Oh, okay. Okay, thank you.
Welcome. Anything else? Anyone has any doubt? So we're good to go then. We can close the call if there are no more doubts. Register for the course to start the training. All right, everyone. See you. Bye-bye. All the very best.
Yeah, bye. Thank you.
Bye, Kalyani. Thank you, Mani. Thanks, Ramoni. Good night. Bye, Mani. Thank you.